Following Enclave installations are hereby ordered to evacuate and relocate to the Chicago Field Operations Bunker. Adams Air Force Base, Raven Rock, Atlas Summit, Apple 7 Echo. We need to do a pit stop in Sanctuary before we advance our interests with the Enclave.
Don't much care for good neighbor. That place is nothing but trouble.
Alright. Well, we've got this all nice and set up. Got a couple industrial plots going. Now we are going to run all the way down to the waypoint to see where this leads us. I will see you all in the next video.
Hey, buddy, you here to help? My friend Jack's in trouble.
I just got here, but yeah.
Okay, good. I can get us in, but first, I need a key. The kind that'll work on any door? The kind that looks like a bobby pin?
Here you go.
Great! Now, before I open this door, I gotta ask, who are you? And can I trust you to help me?
You first. What's your name?
Don't have a name. I'm sort of borrowing a friend's. You can call him Jack. I guess by that logic, I'm not Jack. Or maybe I am? I don't know anymore. The point is, I could be either. I just need to know if you're gonna help me save him.
I'll do what I can.
Perfect. Just follow my lead. Figuratively. I'll be following you inside, literally. So try and look as confused as I made that sound. You'll figure it out once we get inside. All you need to know is, Jack is in trouble, and the clock is ticking. Tick, tick, tick!
Let's do a little roll call, if you don't mind. If you're here, say you're here. Aunt Patty.
Here.
Bobby Craig.
Here.
Arthur D.
Present.
Good. Now that everyone's present and accounted for, here's the deal. This man here is a synth. He's also my prisoner. Now, if you're all wondering why I've locked you inside, well, it's not to keep you in. It's to keep the Institute out. That's right. They got men all over the Commonwealth looking for this sumbitch. So I'd appreciate it if you just showed a little patience while we rest up. Come morning, we'll be over your skin and out of your hair.
But aren't synths dangerous? Why not just shoot them?
Sure. Sure, I could do that. Just cut the damn red wire and let them die. But then who's gonna explain to the scientists over at the facility why their fancy synthetic android is nothing more than a lifeless doll? See, I need him intact, so that they can poke and prod and do whatever it is sciencey types do to their guinea pigs.
Except you've got the wrong guy, Jack. Or should I say, the wrong Jack guy.
And here's your proof
there. There's two of them.
That's right. Two Jacks, one synth.
Yeah, but he's not the synth. I am.
Well, you're certainly as ugly as he is. But short of shooting you dead, I don't suppose you have any proof.
Not really. You can open us up, but chances are you'd find the same bones.
He's right. I heard the Institute makes exact replicas. Right down to the teeth.
You kidding me?
Jesus.
You shouldn't have come, Jack. Now they know. You know how it is, Jack. I just couldn't leave you to die either. That'd be a little too heavy, even for me.
Well, stick me in a jar and call me Dill. This is what I call a real fucking pickle.
Oh, God.
Now what are we gonna do?
It's simple. We lock this place down until we figure out who's got the nuts and who's got the bolts. And I have a feeling this scabber over here can help us. You, come over here.
To be perfectly honest, I don't think the Institute really exists. It's just wild rumors and nonsense.
You know this man? Is what he's saying true? Is he a synth?
Oh, he's a synth, definitely.
If he's a synth, then why the hell was this son of a bitch telling people he works for the Institute? How about this? Why don't you interrogate them for me? I'll be standing here watching you do it. Now, I've got my own opinion, but let's see if we can't come to a consensus.
And just who is this synth, anyway? What do you know about him?
Who? Jack? All I know is what I've heard. One day they say he just started acting different, all cold and unemotional-like. Well, if that doesn't sound like a synth, I don't know what does. But then those same people started saying Jack went back to his normal self, which got me thinking maybe the two of them were working together. Working in shifts, more or less. But there was only one way to find out. So one day, I walked in his house, smacked him with the butt of my gun, and left a note for the other Jack. Wasn't sure if I was crazy, leaving a note for the guy I kidnapped. But seeing as there's a Tweedledee and Tweedledum here, I'd say my hunch was on the button.
I don't have any more questions.
Good. Then you can stop bothering me and start questioning them. You find out which one is the synth, then I take him to my handlers. Easy peasy, Japanesey. But there's one condition. Don't hurt him. Not a scratch, you hear? The contract I have specifically states they're to be delivered undamaged.
I don't know what to think anymore. Hey there.
It doesn't matter which one you ask. Jack and I will give you the same answer. But if you choose wrong, this bounty hunter will come back and finish what he started. Which means the best solution is to kill the hunter and let us go free.
Do you have any friends in the Institute?
I never made any such claim. Whatever he told you is obviously a lie.
Look, I'm sure we can work this out. No one has to die.
You sound like Jack. Always trying to find another way. He's a fool, of course. The shortest distance between two points is a straight line.
Sure, he's been acting a little strange lately, but a synth? That just seems
so
outlandish.
How are you doing?
Never, ever trust a synth.
I think there's a way out of this, without anyone getting hurt.
I can't tell if that's the human or the machine talking.
I get what you're saying, but it seems like it's better to pay attention to the what rather than the who. Anyways, here's my plan. The bounty hunter said we're no good to him damaged, right? So what if we damaged ourselves? You shoot Jack, I shoot non-Jack, and no one has to die. Peace through violence. Just not too much violence. Or else.
Never, I honestly don't know what to believe.
Trust a synth.
It's true, he's been acting different, but is he a synth? That just sounds so far-fetched.
So, did I have the right guy all along?
He's the one.
Yeah, I think so, too. To be honest, I was starting to have doubts. But in times like these, it's best to go with your gut and tell your brain to shut the fuck up.
You're making the wrong choice.
Yeah, you would say that. Thing is, in this country, machines don't get a vote. Now come on, Jack. Time to get back in the box like a good little toaster. we're sending your ass factory sealed.
To be perfectly honest, never I don't trust think the Institute synth. Really exists. It's just wild rumors and nonsense.
I'm not a synth. Of course, that's not the problem. The problem is, you're all idiots.
Hey.
I don't know what to think anymore.
Hmm?
Sure, he's been acting a little strange lately, but a synth? That just seems so outlandish. Hi.
Is there something I can do for you?
Hmm.
Yeah, so this is kind of like the opposite of what I was trying to do.
Ha!
Yeah, so this is kind of like the opposite of what I was trying to do.
Well, that leads nowhere.
Thank you.
Huzzah! Glad that's over. Excellent. Bingo. Nice. Yes. Sweet. Let's just get this over with. Nice. You're not killing. Dead as can be. My pleasure.
October 23rd, 2077. This day, the dust covered the world we knew. The impact killed most people right away. Most of the others died from radiation in the following days. When the bombs fell, I had been in the park with my younger sister, and I saw her death. A wave of radiation was carried to us on the winds of the blast, and people died like writhing bugs as it washed over them. Why did I survive? I don't know. Maybe death would have been better? While I'm writing these words, my nails peel away and my skin melts. I'm looking through a broken window of our flat. A few people who survived walk around the streets searching for their relatives. What will happen to us? Last night I heard a howl. Unhuman. The survivors, they began to change, and I'm changing. My skin falls off in patches. I can't look at myself. I saw my face in the remains of a mirror. I've become a monster. What have I done to deserve this fate? What did my little sister do? October 29th. The physical pain begins to leave. My body seems to regenerate faster than I could expect. My skin starts to get hard and rough. Last night, again, I heard that howl outside. The bodies lying in the street are starting to disappear, leaving behind putrid drag marks. I moved the wardrobe to the window and barricaded the doors. The food I have won't last long. There's no light or electricity. I'm spending the days in total darkness waiting for rescue. I'm scared. October 30th. I took a look outside through a gap between the wardrobe and window. Two, I don't know if I can still call them humans. Two things are fighting each other for the last body lying in the street. The beaten one ran away bleeding. The winner, I swear, he started to eat the rotting corpse. If my stomach wasn't so empty, I would probably puke. I don't know if it's day or night, how many days have passed. My eyes have become accustomed to the dark prevailing in the room. I'm hearing shuffling footsteps and harsh breathing in the corridor outside my flat. Do they know I'm here? I don't believe anymore that help will come. I'm powerless. I can't. I'm hearing their steps, their wild growls, or maybe it's my head. I don't know anymore. I'm hungry and thirsty. The water in tap has a strange metallic taste. It's over. No one's come, and I can't hold anymore. This is my last message. I feel hunger I can't control anymore. Hunger for raw meat. But I'd rather die than change into one of those disgusting things. To Today I'm gonna jump out the window with my diary. If you read this, it means somehow you survived or you've become something compared to me. My name was Mary Roberts, the daughter of Abigail and Charles, older sister of Blair. I was born in 2053 in Boston and died at the age of 19. I could have been whoever I wanted, but this choice was taken. I've lost everything. I still have to decide about my end. I'm choosing death as a human over existence as the monster. Wow. Jeez. Well, that's one hell of a way to go. Alright, we need to keep moving.
Dead as can be. Good riddance. Take the good with the bad, I guess. Finally, it's over.
T60? What's T60 power armor doing in here? Might as well use this while we're in here. Huh. So there's not really much in... There really wasn't much in here except for a glowing one.
Gross.
And a piece of T60 power armor.
Excellent. I really don't care.
But why do I hear a terminal? We might want to keep that one for night. We're going to switch to our Remington.
Yes. My pleasure. Dead as can be. Good riddance. Take the good with the bad, I guess. You're dead. Good riddance. Nice.
Oh.
Human garbage. Was all mine. Want some more?
Lights out, pal.
Sweet.